up, I'm Charlie Greenberg, and this is how to tail whip. So this is the first step to doing a tail whip, and the first step is getting your bunny hops good, high, and clean. So, when you bunny hop, you want to make sure that you get your scooter up and level. Keep it level, and we'll move on to the next step. The second step to learning a tail whip is getting your arms and your legs to move at the same time. What you need to do is practice getting your deck to move in a circular motion, as in tail whip, by moving your arms in a more of like an oval, like you're paddling a canoe, just going down the river. Oh yeah. And it'll get going. And then before you do that, when you actually go to throw the tail whip, kick it and do it. So it's a kick, arms. So once you get step two down, which is using your arms, and kicking the deck around in the same motion, just standing there, doing it, arms and legs. Then what you need to move on to is using your arms and your legs, throwing it, jumping up on the scooter, jumping up, throwing it, landing next to it. Landing next to it will make it so you get used to that motion, but you still don't need to focus on landing on the deck. Once you get used to the motion, landing on the deck will be a piece of cake. And the next step is landing it. The true technique to this is imagining yourself doing this. See? So, what you need to do is when you go to throw your tail whip, look for the deck and try to keep your feet close together, which makes it so when you go to do your tail whip, you will land completely and cleanly on your deck. If you don't suck paid attention to this video, you should be able to do a tail whip. If you want to take this trick to the next level, click my proto gripper.